You guys are trying to take your training to the next level, and you want to increase your speed, your power, your conditioning, then you got to check out Phil Dyrou's 8-week heavy hitter boxing program. I'm telling you guys right now, and it's no joke. Just click on the link in the description box for more information.
What about all the other champions in that division? You got Scott Quigg, Carl Frampton, Guillermo Rigondeaux.
I'm going to get the opportunity, boy. You're booking your ass up, don't you?
Hey, that's what we do. That's what we do.
Deontay's boxing nation. I see it, baby. Y'all the man.
That's what it is.
I love it. I love what you're doing for boxing.
Thank you,
keep
man.
Going, don't stop. Keep on going strong. Keep on going hard. A lot of big fights coming this year. A lot of big fights.
Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? So Keith Thurman, who took a major gamble when it came to avoiding fighters like Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford, thinking that, you know, he was going to basically cash out, or not even cash out, but just wait until he possibly got the shot at Manny Pacquiao, end up losing to Manny Pacquiao, and it basically became another case of cherry picking gone wrong. So now, since Keith Thurman has lost to Manny Pacquiao, now don't get me wrong, the fight was competitive, but since Manny Pacquiao has already made it very clear he ain't giving Keith Thurman a rematch, and we pretty much already knew that wasn't going to happen, this puts Keith Thurman in a very bad situation. Because I can tell you guys right now, if Keith Thurman would have retired, if he would have retired without fighting Errol Spence, and he would have just retired undefeated, of course he would have been criticized, you know, for avoiding Errol Spence. But at least he could have saved face a little bit by saying, hey, I retired undefeated. You know, I beat Danny Garcia. I beat Sean Porter. But now it's not going to look that good because once again, he lost to a 40-year-old Manny Pacquiao, the Manny Pacquiao that Floyd Mayweather beat 4 years ago. When the roles were reversed, when you're comparing Mayweather to Keith Thurman, where Floyd Mayweather was the senior of Manny Pacquiao. He was older than Manny Pacquiao, and he beat a much younger Manny Pacquiao. So this doesn't make Keith Thurman look good at all. And I always tell you guys, what a lot of fighters do in situations like this is they end up trying to make up for their losses. They try to make up for, you know, a big defeat. Right? I tell you, when Manny Pacquiao, when he lost to Floyd Mayweather, he lost the most important fight of his career. He lost the fight of the century, right? So what does he do? If he can't get Mayweather in the ring, if he can't get a rematch, now he's taking on other young lions and he's trying to make up for it. I mean, he can never make up for losing that fight, but at least he can save face. Roberto Duran did the same thing. Roberto Duran, he quit against Sugar Ray Leonard, but you know, he came back and he ended up taking out some young undefeated lions like Davey Moore. He ended up beating Iran Barkley. These were fights that he was supposed to lose, so it made him look a lot better. It kind of made people forget a little bit about the fact that he quit against Sugar Ray Leonard. This is what Manny Pacquiao is attempting to do, and this is what Keith Thurman might be forced to do if he doesn't want to just be remembered once again as the guy that lost to a 40-year-old Manny Pacquiao and avoided Errol Spence. Now, it seems to me like Keith Thurman, he almost has nothing to lose right now. You already know Keith Thurman saying, once again, he always said it, I'm not afraid to let my O go. Now his O is gone. So does he really have anything to lose taking on Errol Spence if Errol Spence beats Keith Thurman? I don't think he has a lot to lose. I mean, I think he'll look the same. He already lost once again to a 40-year-old Manny Pacquiao. So if he were to get in the ring and lose to Errol Spence, honestly, I think he'll get credit just for getting in the ring with Errol Spence, especially after Sean Porter decided to do it. So, you know, I say Keith Thurman is in a tough situation because once again, he didn't really have any interest in fighting Errol Spence anytime soon. But now with him losing to Manny Pacquiao, where does he go from here? I mean, is he going to try to look for a Danny Garcia rematch? I mean, that's a possible fight, but there's really no reason for him to fight Danny Garcia. Danny Garcia hasn't beat any super top welterweight since he lost his last fight to Sean Porter. The only fight that would make sense for Keith Thurman is him going up against a Terrence Crawford or him going up against the winner of Errol Spence and Sean Porter. Let's see what Keith Thurman decides to do. There's also an option where he can just go ahead and retire. But once again, I truly believe that that would make Keith Thurman look worse than it would have made him look if he would have retired undefeated, not fighting against Manny Pacquiao, riding off into the sunset, just been known as the guy that beat Sean Porter and Danny Garcia, but did not want to fight Errol Spence. Let's see what Keith Thurman decides to do, man. Let's see if he decides to fight some young, up-and-coming lions or something like that, like a Virgil Ortiz. I don't think that's going to happen. But, you know, it is what it is. It is what it is. And, of course, Ortiz is a top-ranked fighter, I believe. But let's see. Let's see what Keith Thurman decides to do. That's all I got for now, guys. I'm on to the next one. Yep.